A novena to Saint Louis Marie de Montfort, Day 5. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God of eternal wisdom, you made Saint Louis Marie de Montfort an outstanding witness and teacher of perfect dedication to Christ your Son through his Holy Mother. Grant that we may work with you for the coming of your kingdom, by following the same spiritual path, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Saint Louis de Montfort, you consecrated yourself to Jesus through Mary in your earthly life, and are even more fully devoted to them now in heaven. I ask that you present my petitions before our Most Blessed Mother, who will in turn place them at the feet of her Son. Saint Louis de Montfort, one of the 10 principal virtues that Mary exemplified was surpassing purity. Intercede on my behalf that through God's refining fire I may become ever purer. Amen. Great Apostle and Son of Our Lady, Saint Louis de Montfort, your only desire was to set aflame the world with the love of Jesus through Mary. We implore you to obtain for us a perfect and constant devotion to Mary, that we may participate in the faith, hope, and charity of Our Lady, and that we may receive the favor we ask of you in this novena. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. It was only through Mary that God the Father gave His only begotten to the world. Whatever sighs the patriarchs may have sent forth, whatever prayers the prophets and the saints of the old law may have offered up to obtain this treasure for full 4,000 years, it was only Mary who merited it and found grace before God by the force of her prayers and the eminence of her virtues. The world was unworthy, says Saint Augustine, to receive the Son of God directly from the Father's hands. He gave him to Mary in order that the world might receive him through her. At the marriage of Cana, Jesus changed the water into wine, but it was at Mary's humble prayer, and this was his first miracle of nature. Mary is infinitely below her Son who is God, and therefore she does not commend him as a mother here below would command her child who is below her. Mary, being altogether transformed into God by grace and by the glory which transforms all the saints into Him, asks nothing, wishes nothing, does nothing contrary to the eternal and immutable will of God. When we read then in the writings of Saints Bernard, Bernardine, Bonaventure, and others that in heaven and on earth everything, even God Himself, is subject to the Blessed Virgin, they mean that the authority which God had been well pleased to give her is so great that it seems as if she had the same power as God, and that her prayers and petitions are so powerful with God that they always pass for commandments with His Majesty, who never resists the prayer of his dear mother, because she is always humble and conformed to his will. If Moses, by the force of his prayer, stayed the anger of God against the Israelites in a manner so powerful that the Most High and infinitely merciful Lord, being unable to resist him, told him to let him alone, that he might be angry with and punish that rebellious people, what must we not, with much greater reason, think of the prayer of the humble Mary, that worthy Mother of God, which is more powerful with His Majesty than the prayers and intercessions of all the angels and saints, both in heaven and on earth. The greatest saints, the souls richest in graces and virtues, shall be the most assiduous in praying to our Blessed Lady, and in having her always present as their perfect model for imitation and their powerful aid for help. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in your servants, in the spirit of holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the perfection of your ways, in the truth of your virtues, in the communion of your mysteries. Rule over every adverse power in your spirit for the glory of the Father. Amen. Saint Louis de Montfort, pray for us and obtain for us a true devotion to Jesus, the incarnate wisdom, through a true devotion to Mary. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.